Hey guys, it's Meg Green, CAVHS Health and Wellness Dietitian here, and I just wanted to go over a few tips on general healthy eating. And one of my favorite tools is My Healthy Plate. Maybe you've seen this, and maybe you haven't. A long time ago, we had a food guide pyramid, and now we have moved to My Healthy Plate. And it goes over food groups, the five food groups, and we'll kind of go over those in more specifics. The first one that I always like to start out with is our grain group. And it's really important. Grains are things like pasta, breads, cereals, rice. This is really important to always make sure that you make half of your grains whole wheat. So you want to get some whole wheat bread, 100% whole wheat bread, brown rice. You can use whole wheat pasta. That's more readily available in the stores now than it used to be. And these whole grains, we're gonna give you your fiber, and fiber, of course, is great to help with your digestion and slows things down in your tract so that you stay full for a longer time. And grains is a good source of energy for your body, so you need to make sure that you get those grains. Most of those have a lot of carbohydrates in them, so work with your dietitian to find a good amount that's best for your body. The next group that I like to talk about, of course, is protein, and these are the two most common food groups. Protein, of course, you want to look for more lean proteins. That would be chicken, turkey, pork can be lean. And then eggs also go in there. And there's a few things that you might not think that would go in the protein group. That would be nuts and seeds. And then also there's some legumes that give you protein. And so here you can just see some examples. Cheese is one that is a protein source, but it's also dairy. So you can see I have that both. Just to remind you guys, you do get protein when you do have your dairy group as well. But things like as beef and pork, there's some pork like bacon and sausage that tend to have higher fat. And those fats, you just want to make sure that you have a good balance, and also, of course, work with your dietitian to find out what that balance is for you, because everybody's different. The two other food groups over here that we really focus on, these are our rainbow food groups, because we really want you to eat a good variety of these, and that's fruits and vegetables. They give you lots of vitamins and minerals. And so with fruit, this is a really good time of the year to really try new and different fruits that maybe you're not familiar with, because a lot of these are in season. And you want to make sure when you use this method of My Plate that you have one of these food groups on your plate. And we'll go over that in just a sec. The other really important one is vegetables. And this is one that you want to make sure and eat a veggie with every meal if you can. And just like fruits, you want to eat a good variety of vegetables. That can go from lots of green vegetables, from leafy greens like spinach, kale, lettuces, then of course like broccoli, asparagus, okra, but you also have tomatoes and beets and eggplants, bell peppers. There's such a big variety. Now, some vegetables also will give some carbohydrate as well, starch. They can be starchy. Those would be potatoes, sweet potatoes, corn. So you want to make sure and use the right amounts of those with your dietitian for your diet and what's best for your body. Then last, of course, we have our dairy group. That would be anything dairy, so milk, yogurt, cheese, and that's from cow, from goat, from sheep. All of those are in the dairy, and you want to get a good variety of that as well. And try and do low fat dairy if you can. So here is my plate. So when you think about these food groups and you want to make a meal, you want to think about putting all of the pieces of this puzzle on your plate. So for instance, let's say we were going to do a meal here. We could do a steak, and this would be our protein. We could also have some pasta for our grain, 100% whole wheat pasta, of course. We'll add some dairy with milk. We can do cantaloupe with fruit, and then let's go ahead and add some roasted okra, is one of my favorites. And here you go. You've got a really balanced nutritious meal and you're hitting all of your food groups. So your body's going to get all of those vitamins, minerals, nutrients, everything that it needs to work in its best form when you're able to kind of meet all of these food groups. It's lucky to have a plate that shows you exactly where things need to go, but just think of it as a puzzle. And so if you don't have one of these handy dandy plates, that's okay. You can just use a regular plate and think about it in, or even in the cafeteria here, we get those to-go plates. And so this is what throws people. You want your protein to go in one of those little small containers, and then also your whole grain. And the big portion where most people put their entree, that's where you want to load up on your veggies and your fruit. And so any plate will work, like you see here, even though this is kind of divided. Any plate will work, you just want to make sure. And then dairy most of the time is off to the side, so grab a glass of milk or know that you'll have some yogurt. But this is how eating healthy for the general population goes. My Plate has a website, choosemyplate.gov, that has lots of tips, tricks, recipes, and goes over every food group in detail. So visit that website if you have any questions or concerns. Plus, always contact your dietitian to know what's best for you and get an individualized plan. And hope you guys enjoy.